Hello and welcome back to Music Mitra. My name is Bindu Nair and you're watching this channel which discusses Carnatic music in a very informal way. So if you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe and click the bell icon so you know when new videos on Carnatic music, simple learning tips are shared with you. So today's topic is how do we start our learning process of Carnatic music. We have very structured lessons which date back to nearly 500 years back from the time of Purandaradasa, who is considered as the Sangeeta Pitamaha. He is the person who is supposed to have set in order the structure of lessons that we follow even today. So that is why our kind of music has a very rich heritage and you know history behind it. So the basic raga that is selected for learning the lessons as a beginner is Maya Malava Gaula. Maya Malava Gaula is a Janaka raga or a parent raga, part of the 72 Melakarta table. Now if you have seen my earlier videos on this 72 parent ragas, you will know what I'm talking about. If not, please go back and watch that video so you understand what I'm talking about. So there are 72 Melakarta ragas, so parent ragas or Janaka ragas in Carnatic music from which other ragas are born. So Maya Malava Gaula is one such raga which comes as number 15 in the 72 list of ragas. Now why Maya Malava Gaula? From what I have learned and what my gurus have told me is that Maya Malava Gaula is a simple raga in the sense that as a beginner you are not used to singing, you know, very difficult type of notes. So here Maya Malava Gaula is a very simple raga in the sense that even without gamakas this raga can hold its structure. As you know, many ragas in Carnatic music are rich in gamakas or modulation of notes. So that can be difficult for a beginner. Whereas Maya Malava Gaula is simple. We can sing it even without using gamakas. That is number one. Another very important reason for choosing Maya Malava Gaula, which I feel is the transition from one swara to another in Maya Malava Gaula for Sarigamapa and Padanisa is very easy. So the jump from Ri to Ga, same jump from Dha to Ni. So the first part is the same as the second part. For example, I'll explain to you. This has got Shuddha Rishabham Ri 1, Sa Ri 1, Ga 3 or Antara Gandharam, Ma Shuddha Madhyama, Panchamam, Shuddha Devatam or Da 1 and Kakali Nishadam or Ni 3. So that space between Ri 1 and Ga 3 or the Shuddha Rishabham and Antara Gandharam here is the same as the distance between Da 1 and Ni 3. So when someone learns to sing Sarigama, the same way we can sing Padanisa into the higher frequency. For example, I'll sing and show you. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Ni Sa. Now if you observe, Sa Re Ga Re Ga, that difference from Re to Ga is same as Pa Da. Reason I heard from some of my gurus is that there is a distance between notes. There are one distance, one unit distance, two unit distance, three unit distance. this raga has all these covered in this. That I'll not explain now because it will be too confused to understand. So this raga uses all the different gaps that are possible between the swaras. So this is considered as an ideal raga to start one's training in Carnatic music. Now how do we start? We start with an exercise called Sarali Varise. Sarali itself means easy, easy phrases, Sarali Varises. It's also called Swaravali exercises. Swaravali, swaras meaning notes, vali meaning stringing together and making an exercise out of that. So how the first lesson is structured is that we go gradually from note to note, giving emphasis to one note at a time, starting with the first exercise being the Arohana Avarohana of Mayamala Gaula. That is Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Ni Sa, Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re Sa. That's the first exercise. That is, we learn to sing this raga in its Arohana Avarohana by placing each note in its correct place. And the tala we use for this is called Adi Tala because we have 8 places. Sa, Ri, Ga, Ma, Pa, Da, Ni, the 7 swaras, and you culminate on the next octave Sa. So you sing the higher Sa. And then so we have 8 places. So the talam goes like this, Adi Talam. Beat, small finger, second finger, middle finger, beat, open, beat, open. So it is Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Ni Sa, Sa Ni Ta Pa Ma Ga Re Sa. So that is the exercise one. Now once you learn to sing that, we start focusing on one note at a time. So the first note we focus is Re. So what we do? Sa Re, Sa Re, Sa Re Ga Ma. And in the Avarohanam we focus on Ni. Sa Ni, Sa Ni, Sa Ni Da Pa. So the second verse or exercises Sari 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 Gama, Sari Gama Padanisa, Sani 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 Dapa, Sani Dapa Magarisa. Then the third, we focus on the next note in the Arohanam being Ga. So Sari Ga, Sari Ga, Sari. So we paused on that Ga for 2 times so that we feel the place of the Ga and we are learning to understand and get a muscle memory in our head for where the Ga is supposed to be. Same thing, now we go to the next verse will be Sari Ga Ma, the fourth note. Sari Ga Ma, Sari Ga Ma, Sari Ga Ma. So see, emphasis was on Ma. The next verse will be, emphasis will be what? Pa, right? Easy. So Sa Re Ga Ma Pa, Sa Re. Same way in the Avarohanam it will be Ma. Sa Ni Da Pa Ma, Sa Ni. So that is how the next verse. Now sixth one will be, after Pa is Dha. So Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da, Sa Re. So Pa Da Da Da, we are focusing on the Da here. The next one is Ni. Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da Ni. So here we learn to focus on the Ni. Same way while coming down we focus on the Re. Sa Ni Da Pa Ma Ga Re. Understood how each varise has a purpose. why it is structured in that manner is because we are learning to focus on one note at a time. So that is how the lessons are structured for us to understand each note one at a time. Now in my next video, I'll share more details on how one starts to learn Carnatic music. So I wish you all the best to find a guru who can teach you, hold your hand. And for some of you who've been telling me that you're still not able to find a teacher and you would like some help, I have WhatsApp based programs for those who want to learn the basics. And please email me at sanskritiacademymusic@gmail.com so I can send you the details. That is only on the condition that you cannot find a teacher. As I told you, no online lessons can substitute a real guru in life. Okay, so I will put my email address in the description below. Please write to me if you need help, or even if you want to find a teacher in your area, I can help you. In our network of teachers, I can maybe find a teacher for you. And hope to see you soon in my next video. And listen to more music, learn more about music, and have a great day. Thank you.